Even fasting without faith doesn't produce. Don't forget, when Jesus was talking to the disciples, they said, why couldn't we cast this devil out? The first thing Jesus said, he said, because of your unbelief. Then he says, howbeit, this goeth not, except through prayer and fasting. I can bring somebody out now, and I'll ask another brother to cast out the devil. Be shouting, out, 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 out. I said, come on, out, out. The evening, out, out. Another one will just come by faith. I say, come out. And the spirit will cry out. The one that is shouting, out, 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 come out. He has no faith. He could have been fasting. Because what triggers the supernatural, whether you are fasting, whether you are sowing, whether you are praying, the faith factor. Hebrews 11 verse 6 summarizes it. He said, without faith, it is impossible to please God. The reason why some of you cannot do anything in the house of God is you lack the faith. You have put yourself in the company of people that will kill every faith in you to give, to tithe, to sow, to pray, to fast. When you hang around unbelievers, people who don't believe in things that are godly, they'll destroy your faith and they'll kill it. And when they kill it, you have nothing to sustain it and nothing to push it. So that's why you see sometimes you're fasting. You just say, I better give me food. You see, no faith anymore. You don't even believe in the exercise because you have been hanging around the wrong crowd. Psalm 1, verse 1, it says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of your God, nor seated in the seat of discomfort.
Say there's an army.
There's an army rising up.
Oh, yeah.
There's an army rising up.
Yeah. There's an army. Yeah.
There's an army rising up.
On Friday, the 1st of this month of January 2020, I'm asking you to be part of an all-night service. It's a powerful Holy Ghost meeting. The theme of this program is Breaking the Limits. 2020 has been declared to us by the Holy Spirit as a special year to unlimit you from everything that stands as an impediment to your next level. It's a special night vigil where the power of God will move in the area of healing, deliverance, and prophecy. The Bible says the Lord is that Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. God spoke to me about this meeting. I'm looking forward with great anticipation for your healing, your miracles, and my blessings. This will be a special night of impartation. Don't forget that the first Friday, 10 p.m. at number 11, Awori Street, Lake Palaji bus stop. Come with your loved one. Come with your family. It's going to be a special anointing. The first night vigil for 2020. Don't forget, it's your year of unlimited breakthroughs. Get ready for this special meeting. My name is Dr. Antoni Okoh, lead pastor, Sovereign World Church.
Is the spirit troubling you? I'm seeing a woman around you, pointing towards you to kill you. There's a woman on your neck. I'm seeing her holding an axe on your shoulder. Come. Stand by this man. What is your name?
Adeola.
What is your name?
Adeola.
Why are you looking at her like that?
You're bearing the same name.
Now, you are surprised. Is this your first time here?
Yes.
Who is this woman that wants you dead?
I met her 2014.
2000 what?
I'm 14.
14. What did you do to her?
When I met her, she said she was married and that her husband left her. So, I started to
date her. At some point, you decided to back out.
Yes.
You decided to back out. And then she now threatened you. Huh?
Yes, sir.
What did she say she would do?
Make me wrong, man.
That's the spirit already at work. I'm sorry to say. It's like you were losing control over your like an imbalance.
Yes, sir.
And when she told you were going to go, man, what happened next?
I felt like a sponge didn't tell me. Like a hand. Things like a hand that has.
In a dream.
Yes, and I saw the thing
enter your head. Yes. How long did you date this woman?
It wasn't up to a month. What actually happened was that I was trying to help her. I didn't know the kind of person she was. So she
slept with you?
Yes. So after that, she kept on telling me she will marry me. She kept on telling me that I had this glory.
Huh? Use the word you used just a minute ago. That you had what?
Glory.
Huh?
That I had the glory.
Uh-huh.
That she will marry me. She must marry me.
I'm a part of the glory.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
So you can see what attracted her to you was what? Huh? Your what?
Glory.
And then what has she has attacked now?
She has been attacking the glory.
Huh?
She has been attacking the glory.
Attacking the glory. Now you see what we're preaching. You see, 90% of spiritual battles are centered around glory.